we're likely closer to the next recession than we were to the last one. What do you say to people who think we should be balancing the budget or running surpluses to save up for a rainy day, for when the next downturn comes?
I think we all know that we need to ensure that our country is resilient against challenges. There are economic cycles. By being fiscally responsible, we think we are resilient to face up to those challenges. Having the lowest net debt to GDP of G7 countries means comparatively we're in a particularly good situation. Ensuring that goes down puts us in an increasingly better situation. We're going to keep focused on having what we hope will be strong growth rates, keep focusing on confidence of our Canadian families, and we think that the balance of those measures puts us in a very good position. And for your viewers, we know that it means that when they look at places where they're going to invest around the world, they can look at Canada and say, you know, that's a place where they've got a balance, they've got a very stable situation, and something that's going to work for the long term.
I want to ask you about one risk in particular. Of course, NAFTA talks and Trump administration policy decisions, you've in effect baked those in two ways through your, you know, projections for your baseline growth rate and that $3 billion risk adjustment. How big a risk are these NAFTA talks? What kind of fiscal shock could we see if things don't go as we hope?
Well, as you know, we have the U.S. as our largest trading partner. So we do need to have a continuing strong relationship. You know, many things that we trade with the United States are, things that are at a fairly low tariff rate. We think that would continue under any scenario. We do know that NAFTA is critically important for us to get right, and that's why we're working hard to do that. We've seen, I think, you know, there's some challenging days with any negotiation. We've also seen that we've extended the date, so we have more time to get it right. In our projections, our fiscal projections, we have an expectation of growth, but we're not overestimating so that we can, you know, underperform against that. We're being prudent. So the estimation of growth is cautious, and we always put in a cushion, fiscal cushion for unexpected events. And that's just the way that we budget in Canada. It's a way that we think is careful. And does acknowledge that there are risks. It's not only the risk with NAFTA, but of course, you know, we could see global growth slow down. On the other hand, there are upside risks. We've grown over the last year much faster than we expected. We could see growth faster internationally than we expected. So there's increasingly more of a balanced set of risks than there have been for the last couple of years.
Do you think you'd need to at least consider new policy measures, stimulus, if you will, if Trump pulled out of NAFTA, if NAFTA talks collapse? Would Canada need some sort of 08-09 style intervention by the federal government in that scenario?
We're going to keep working on NAFTA, and we're going to consider what the right decisions are along the way. I think what we can say is we've clearly made the right decisions so far. Investing in Canadian families has made a real difference in growth. We think that working constructively with the United States and Mexico is the only way to get to a good conclusion of the NAFTA talks. We're going to keep doing that. And we'll face the future when the future comes.